MGTOW, MGTOW, MGTOW. You know something? Nature finds a way. Nature always finds a way. And that's the topic of today's video. Today's red pill. Now imagine if it was logical. A good looking guy walks out, sees a hot woman on the street, and then they go to his house or some quiet place and just make out for fun, you know? But no, it's all those stupid fucking games with him. Shit test. All the time with their fucking shit test, you know? And what they don't know, women, what women don't know, is that that quiet guy in the street that they pass by, that guy that's simply walking at retail, stacking some shelf, that guy that is cleaning their office. We don't know, but when he goes home, he may be working on AI. He may be 3D printing sex dolls, you know? If they're not willing to do their fucking job, it is inevitable that someone or something else will do their job. It is a scientific principle called the Le Chatelier principle, okay? I can't just tell a guy, you know something, man? I like you. Let's do something together, no? We need to call him to ask him if he's gay. Them being ugliest bitches is not at all taken under consideration. Them being co-workers, it's not a reason for them. Why the fuck would a sane guy hit on a woman in his workplace? Under today's laws, with all the risk. So in their minds, the only reason is this guy gay? It all comes to those stupid bottom lines with those cunts. I don't give a fuck how you look. Only give a fuck about your resources. For example, if you keep excellent care of your teeth, you have excellent teeth. To them, they simply lower the cost of dental treatments. They simply add it to your overall net worth. How much you make, what car do you have. So a guy with terrible rotten teeth would be the equivalent with an expensive sports vehicle would be more attractive when a guy with excellent teeth and a bicycle, even though the guy with the bicycle would have a nice firm buttocks, which women say they like all the time. They're always looking for cute butts. But a fat guy with rotten teeth in an expensive vehicle, it's much more appealing to them. And when they do those fucking shit tests, it's not like... No, many blue pillers, they don't understand how the female brain works. They think maybe she's trying to see if you are interested in her because she is interested in you. No! She is doing what you're doing when you check your phone battery. How much is left in the phone battery. We simply check if they're hot, if they are pre-wall. That's it. When you start taking red pills, you start to see through the matrix. And it's fucking amazing. Why is it amazing? It's because MGTOW doesn't give a fuck about did he get the right answer. For MGTOW, just not, you simply don't play that game. He tells you, are you gay? No, not gay. That's it. Not would you like to go out? Would you like to, because you know what she's gonna say. Because you need to display money to attract her. How did this MGTOW thing start? Huh? When did it start to explode? When that guy Vitalize did that gold digger prank. Suddenly shit starts to come together. Shit makes sense. She'll be like, oh, I love you. You haven't dated. She's a co-worker. A co-worker will tell you, I love you. It doesn't mean shit. That's what they do. They say stuff all with double meanings. A blue pillar would sit around all day long trying to analyze. Does she like me? Should I hit on her? Would she reject me? A red pill guy would simply go home and either fuck a sex doll or order a prostitute. As simple as that. Or take a trip to Thailand, to Bangkok, Koh Samui, Pattaya, where pussy is cheap and you don't play those fucking mind games. See? So MGTOW lets those co-workers just dry up, all the way, hit the wall, spend all their money on stupid dresses and shoes. Let them waste thousands of dollars on hair treatments and weavings. Just go home. Fuck the doll. Believe me, if